Seekers, I'm Nick. I decided that I wanted to go down the rabbit hole and explore something that I've never really done before because I've been using NVIDIA GPUs for pretty much the longest time ever. You can read articles, blog posts, and watch countless YouTube videos about AMD's Crossfire, but none of it means anything unless you can see it with your own eyes. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you hit that button right now. Turn on the little bell to receive notifications. We upload about 4 times a week. I think it's like 5 or 6 this week. Yeah, so yeah, make sure you're subscribed. Now, the only problem I had with this whole Crossfire thing was I didn't have 2 identical AMD GPUs and I didn't know whether or not I could still do Crossfire without having 2 of the exact same GPUs. So yeah, let's find out what happened. Spoiler alert. It works. You're gonna wanna watch to see how it all works. Also, before you leave stupid comments, watch the whole video first. This video is brought to you by Cooler Master and the MasterCase H500M, featuring interchangeable front panels, 2 giant 200mm addressable RGB fans for the ultimate airflow, and all of the front I/O you could possibly ever want. Find out more about the MasterCase H500M at the link in the description. Okay, let's talk about how we're testing this. Now, we're using a similar system to the one that we used when we tested the ASRock Phantom Gaming RX 580. The motherboard is the ASRock X470 Fatality Gaming K4 with a Ryzen 5 2600 and 16 gigs of TeamGrip T-Force memory at 3000 megahertz. Now, I threw in the ASRock Phantom Gaming RX 580 AGOC that we tested a few weeks ago. You can check out that video right now in the top right-hand corner as well. And along with that, we chucked in a Gigabyte Aorus RX 580 4GB, and to be honest, I didn't know what to expect and I thought that it probably wasn't going to work, but to my surprise, it worked without me even having to enable anything. So yeah, I'm guessing most people in the comments will say that I should have known that it would work, but seriously, I never even thought about trying this at all until like Saturday afternoon. You know when you're like tinkering with stuff on a Saturday and you're like, oh, I wonder if that'll work. Well, that's basically what happened. Anyway, we tested the Crossfire setup with 2 titles that I know should technically scale pretty well with Crossfire. And yeah, I just wanted to see how big of a difference it would actually make if you could run Crossfire. So in every single test, the GPUs were running at their factory settings. Just keep in mind that both of these cards are factory overclocked as well, but only by a little bit. So yeah, it doesn't actually add to the performance that much. So yeah, let's start off with the Rise of the Tomb Raider benchmark. We did single card testing in our ASRock Phantom Gaming RX 580 video, so we'll use those results again so we don't have to retest. The first set of tests, we did everything set to high in DirectX 11. With the single card at 1080p, we saw an average frame rate of 75 frames per second and a maximum frame rate of 116 frames per second. In Crossfire at 1080p, we saw an average frame rate of 85 frames per second with a maximum frame rate of 217 frames per second. That's a lot of frames. Already we're seeing a trend and we're only one test in. Because we're using multiple GPUs, we decided that we wanted to add some 4K tests in as well. In 4K, we saw an average frame rate of 48 frames per second with a maximum frame rate of 141 frames per second. That's not too bad. I mean, that's playable. Anyway, from tests with some other titles in DirectX 12 with cards above 4 gigs, I found that DX 12 performance is usually better than its DX 11 counterpart, but again, it's dependent on the game. So yeah, we tested Rise of the Tomb Raider in DX 12 as well, just to make sure. With a single card with DX 12 in 1080p, we saw an average of 75 frames per second with a maximum frame rate of 117 frames per second. That's actually pretty close to the DX 11 result. With a single card with DX 12 in 4K, we saw an average frame rate of 26 frames per second with a maximum frame rate of 40 frames per second. Now, here's what I actually wasn't expecting. With Crossfire enabled with DX 12 in 1080p, we saw an average frame rate of 114 frames per second with the maximum frame rate of 225 frames per second. With Crossfire enabled with DX12 in 4K, we saw an average frame rate of 59 frames per second with a maximum frame rate of 94 frames per second. That's a pretty solid increase. That's almost double the frame rate, and I think it's because Crossfire generally scales better in DX12. I'd like to visit this again in another video though, because I'm still not quite convinced. Okay, let's get into the Quake Champions test. You knew it was coming. Come on, it's me. Everything needs to be tested with Quake. But the reason isn't just because I love Quake Champions, it's that it actually markets Quake Champions as being optimized for AMD GPUs, whereas we know that in truth, it really isn't. We did a video about that and you can check that out in the top right-hand corner right now. So yeah, let's see the numbers. Going off the results of our ASRock Phantom Gaming RX 580 benchmark video, we also know how it should perform with a single card. So let's go over those results to quickly refresh our memory. With a single card in 1080p, we saw an average frame rate of 114 frames per second with a maximum frame rate of 134 frames per second. With a single card in 4K high with 90% texture scaling, we saw an average frame rate of 62 frames per second and a maximum frame rate of just 73 frames per second. What do you mean just? That's pretty good. Okay, now we upped the ante and did the rest of all of the tests in ultra and not high because, well, why not? Like, we've got more video memory, we've got more GPUs, why not? With Crossfire enabled in 1080p Ultra, we saw an average frame rate of 116 frames per second with a maximum frame rate of 119 frames per second. Now to me, that's telling me that the frame rates are actually a bit more stable. With Crossfire enabled in 4K Ultra, we saw an average frame rate of 56 frames per second with a maximum frame rate of 61 frames per second. Now, given that that's not a direct comparison between single card performance, you can get an idea of how well Crossfire actually scales. We up the texture quality and the texture scaling, and technically it performs better than the lower setting. If you do the math in your head, that makes sense. Anyway, overall, Crossfire performed better than I expected it to. In fact, it worked without me having to switch AFR modes like I have to do with SLI, although you can do that if you want, but I didn't need to. We got the best results in all of the testing from using the default settings. So yeah, just keep that in mind if you're thinking about doing a Crossfire setup of your own. Now, should you buy two RX 580s and put them in Crossfire instead of buying like one really good powerful GPU? Probably not. But if you have one RX 580 and wanted to take the power up another level without forking out for a whole like top level GPU, it's an option, but yeah, I probably wouldn't do it because yeah, it's still money that you don't have to spend, but it's pretty cool, like for testing. Anyway, I'd love to explore this a bit further. If you can think of some titles or benchmarks you think we should use that scale well with Crossfire, let me know in the comments and yeah, we'll play around with them. I'm actually pretty keen to play around with this a bit more. It was one of those like, I'm bored on a Saturday afternoon type of videos where I just needed to test something. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this odd benchmarking video. Didn't make much sense. Let us know in the comment section down below if you think we should make more of these kind of videos. Also, shouts to TechForge Australia for saying we should do more of these videos in the last benchmarking video. Go and subscribe to Nate's channel. There is a link in the description and also on the end card. Get him to 100 subscribers, guys. He actually deserves it, but like actually deserves it. The guy makes some really good videos. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. If you didn't like this video, you know what to do. And yeah, tell us what you didn't like about it. Please tell us what you didn't like about it. Once again, thanks so very much for watching. I'm Nick with Gear Seekers. You peek, we seek. And the only problem with this Crossfire setup is, listen how loud this thing is. I think we should water cool it.